Turn on the torch, light up the flame, time to melt some glass, my friends. There you are. Here I am to explain, to teach, and create again. Tonight, we're going to do something that I have been playing with for about 3 or 4 days now, and it's been a while, I know, but I've been doing this honeycomb look in a lot of my pieces lately that have turned out so sweet, and I think I've finally gotten to the point where I can say that it's some type. This is silver fume, and you can see the blues, and you can see the yellows, and a little bit of green. That's what a lot of people are looking for. And I am going to try and help you guys through this and see if we can't all get a little bit of not just silver shiny gold flavor going on, but some of those colors on the inside. This is a honeycomb that I have developed in the last little while. Here's a turtle too, by the way. Ain't that sweet? Anyway, but this is a little thing that I have developed, and it has worked out, and it has been giving me continuous. These last couple of them show that the color is coming through continuously, and not just, oops, it came through this time, and no, it didn't come through the next time. So let's see if I can do this, make it happen one more time, if not two or three later on, but that's beside the point, right? Right. Okay, first of all, I'm doing this on a little bit of tubing. This is I want to say 10 or 12 heavy wall, and I'm going to make a nice little bubble to start this up. This is going to be, let there be fire. Here we go. Anyway, and now we're going to just make a bubble on the end of this thing, and then we're going to put a whole bunch of dots. The dots are what's going to make the honeycomb sewer fume come through and look pretty. It's gonna look pretty. Yep. This whole pandemic stuff has really gotten, I want to say, the better of me, and I haven't been doing much. And I probably should have been doing one a week at least. I shouldn't have been talking while I was working. I seal it up is what first step. Now I'll just make a nice long wide bubble. Not a wide one, but just enough to make a honeycomb effect on. A little bit more. Okay. Now I'm going to take a stringer that I've done, bring down the, darn, pressure was a little bit too high. Let's get this right. There we go. Just a nice little flame. And what I'm going to do is make a dot matrix going on. And it's going to cover the top part of this bubble. And I'll keep going around and keep getting it until the whole top part is covered like a porcupine. This is, if I was doing fast forward, this would probably be a good time to do that, but I'm gonna let you go through at the same speed that I'm going through. And I'm heating up the one on the right and just touching it to the one on the left. It doesn't have to be a good seal because it is going to be a good seal in the end anyway, so don't worry about the stress levels on it in the long run. You'll see what I'm talking about. Because after it's all said and done, I'm going to sort of let it all flatten into itself. Now these stringers come in handy. I take the end pieces that are chunky and crappy like this and pull it off into a stringer, and then I can use it into this stuff later on, so it's not like a waste. Where was I? Oh well. Somewhere near the top, I guess. That should do it. Now, I've gone ahead and you know you've seen me silver fume, and right here on the end of this punte, there I have a little bit of silver on there, and it's just basically boro. It's the way I work with it. Now what I'm going to do is just let the, wait, that's a little bit too sharp of a flame. You need a really high, almost a bushy flame, but not quite a bushy flame, to get the best results from silver. Here we go, and let the smoke dance. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Keep it up for a little while longer, not much. Yeah. See? Now we're gonna collapse that, basically. And I'm going to use the blow hose and sort of suck in and puff out, but very, very lightly now. Out of ring wouldn't hurt, but it doesn't have to be. But I'm going to do it anyway. Sucking in and blowing out slightly. Collapsing the bubble. With me so far, huh? Now, I'm going to layer clear over all of it. And this is like 10 or 11, 12 mil heavy wall. No, this is solid rock, excuse me. Stupid me. We'll get there. I'm going to do this twice around. This is the way I layer like on the sea turtles and stuff like that. But this is sort of important. The thicker it is, the better it, just make it thick. That's all I got to say. Now I'm heating up the one in my right and adding it to the one in my left. Paper and pencil routine, if you remember that from any of my other videos. Okay, now melted in. And just a little off view here, I have an elm arbor. I'm going to use it. Actually, I could probably do it like this, I'll show you. Yeah. Sort of flattening the surface there. Looking good.
Yeah.
We're gonna go and do the same thing to the other side. We're gonna blow out the bubble. Now add clear to the what was the inside of the bubble. Blowing it out, getting it really thin. That practically goes right to the edge. Yeah. Looking for something that's never around, right?
Right.
Never square either. There it is. I didn't realize that. I'll raise the bar, as it were, gently. There we go. Now we're going to add clear to the bottom. Here we go. It's important to encase the fuming on both sides. Just basically do the same thing I did to the top, do it to the bottom now. And I am going to try to go around twice. One second time around. A little bit more. There we go. Little bit more glass, not a lot. Just a little. There we go. Looks like I got a lot more on the bottom than I did on the top, but that's okay. Down.
Now.
cap off that. Put a cold weld there. I just sort of melt it in a little. Both sides. This is where heating it up and letting the silver fuse with the glass a little bit more than is where the color change. The crystallization of the silver into the glass come to affect it, as you can see. Now I'm going to stretch this, flatten it a little bit both sides, keep stretching. Half of this is going to be the head and half of it's going to be the neck for the dragon head that I'm doing there. Gravity works. Bring it down. Move it around. There we go. Together. Shaping the nose as we go. Go. Oh yeah, we got a little bit angled, but we can fix that just by heating and nudging. See? There we go. Okay. Now I'm going to use these tweezers right here to help define the eyebrows on the dragon's face. Okay, I'm going to take it down a few notches. Doesn't need to be that loud, as it were. And this also helps you to put them across from each other where you're going to put the eyes. Okay. Now, the next step is this. This has an eye milli in there. Of course you can't see it, but it's there. Oh yeah, you can, sorry. And in the eye milli, I will put one eye on one side. Let it cool, get it back and forth. Not enough, I gotta do it again, darn it. You gotta get enough to let it show up. Oh, that gave it a little bit too much, but doable. Again, I figure out where the eye is. hatch. Let it cool. Break it off. There's one eye and the other eye. We're good. Now what you also can do, if you tap it just, or do it just right, only have a little bit of glass there, to make the eye more rounded and magnify the lens of the eye itself. Just heat, dab, heat and dab. Now I'm gonna try a green, shade of green anyway, for the top of the eyebrows and the horn. Yeah, that eye's a little bit bulgy, but it'll get there. I'm still working on the basic shape of these guys, but they are pretty nice, as it were. And as you can see, some of those colors are coming through on that fume piece. Just keep heating it a little bit. And now the horns. Sweet, looking good.